Even the demons believe and shudder. Do you want to be shunned, you senseless person that faith apart from works is sinners? Was not our ancestor Abraham justified by works when he offered his son Isaac on the altar? You see that faith was active along with his works. And faith was brought to completion by his works. Thus the scripture was fulfilled that says Abraham believed God and it was reckoned to him as righteousness. And he was called the son of God. You see that a person is justified by works and not by faith alone. Likewise, was not Rahab, the prostitute, also justified by works when she welcomed the messengers and sent them out by another way? For just as the body without the spirit is dead, so faith without works is also dead. Brothers and sisters, this is the word of God for us, the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
In the beginning, there is nothing but darkness and void and terror. And when God spoke, light became. He formed the heavens on the earth. He made creatures. He separated the land from the ocean. And then, God, the Lord of heaven and earth, he came into the soil and grabbed the soil and formed and shaped us, humanity. And in that dust, in that soil, God really touched and breathed life into our lives. God left his flesh in heaven, came into our dirt, into our soil. He was close enough for us to feel his warm breath without helping him. He did that for the 14 of you. And he is that close today to human scenario on the cross. Here at Pleasant Grove United Methodist Church, we've been in a sermon series entitled Practical Divinity. We've been looking at the book of James, and how James lets us know, unpacks for us, how we put our faith in God into everyday practical application. How we put our faith into action. Last week we talked about how James said, here's what purity is, carefully, not passive, will, the orphan, patient, spiritual, unpacking. And he makes us a lot of that to tell us now, how do we how do we put this into action? And James here at the end of chapter 2, he's addressing probably something that's happened in his church. I say probably something that's happened in his church because as a pastor for 10 years now, these things have happened to me in my church. This is experience. And he's addressing this open this issue. It was a lie that his time, it's been a lie that throughout the centuries in his life today, how do you balance faith and work? And he has this scenario that, hey, let's just say somebody, you better call out names, and that's a great pastor not to call out names. You don't like your names being called out by a pastor, do you? That's never a good thing. And then, some of you will say, somebody who doesn't have any from the emotions, from the desires. And so if you saw somebody who needed clothing, the emotion of pity would come up. Maybe the emotion of compassion. And so the Christians have got to free themselves from these emotions, from these feelings. And so you have Christians who are trying to be like that. Trying to try to identify with that, trying to free themselves from all emotions and all instructs the people to say every day, wake up and say, the Lord our God, the Lord is one, and so love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your body, and with all your mind. And pray to the back of your hands and on the door kind of speaks to my heart. And he said that when David said, when you say that kind of one, he's talking about the Mosaic command to say every day, the Shema, the Lord. Somehow, some way, God has touched you, you might open.